to me peasants, I bid you a welcome to this day at Wat Tyler Park. Enjoy this programme, lest you feel the length of my blade.
Brave words indeed from Colonel Payne of the Blue Regiment. Colonel, welcome to Wat Tyler Country Park for the Heritage Day. Now then, you are a parliamentarian, are you not?
Indeed.
And the name of your regiment is the Blue Regiment of the what?
Of London Trained Bands.
Now, you dress up like this, do you, sort of in your spare time or weekends to do this sort of thing?
Yeah, well, we're members of the Sealed Knot and we reenact Civil War battles all over the country.
And what makes you do it? I mean, why don't you just play a good, nice game of golf or something like that?
Well, there's a lot of different facets to the Sealed Knot. There is obviously an interest in history, but it's with good friends. There's a lot of camaraderie and we're all together, all got our uniforms.
Yes.
And just makes a good weekend.
Yes, and as you've got all the gear here, I mean, can you explain some of it to me? It looks marvellous. You've got a nice sort of breastplate thing there, haven't
you? So I'm better equipped than most of the common soldiery.
Yes.
I've got, obviously, a breastplate, which obviously gives me a good protection.
Yes.
But under it wears a stout leather coat.
Yes.
That would stop an average sword cut.
Yes.
Long leather boots.
Yes.
Would protect my legs. And my trusty sword arm.
Right, look, it's beginning to rain, I believe.
Indeed.
Now, I take it, when you get this stuff on, you really do feel like you've got the Civil War feeling.
Yeah, you get the feeling. Would you like to try some on?
Yeah, what a great idea, actually. I'll do that.
Soldier, bring this man some armour.
Ah, here comes a trusty fellow.
This would have been a pikeman's armour. I've had a good hard morion to protect his head.
Yes.
Slip that over.
Oh,
that's it.
It's a bit tight, too. They had small heads in those days, didn't they?
Yeah, we don't want to lose it in the midst of battle.
I think I'm going to have to pass my my speaking stick to my trusty assistant here. Thank you.
Pikeman, come and help me. Look for your breastplate, your chassis to protect your vital parts.
Oh, and they are very vital.
And then, something to protect your back.
Yes.
Although we don't expect our soldiers to turn their backs on the enemy.
I suppose there's nasty cavaliers could sneak up from behind, didn't they?
Well, not if you keep facing them.
Oh, right. And maybe running away at the
finally,
time.
A belt to hold the whole thing together. Pull that nice and tight.
I'm already beginning to feel quite invincible. I think if I had a pike in my hands, I'd feel quite great.
And then, normally underneath, this would be your pike. 16 foot long, keep the enemy at bay.
Can you give me any sort of blood-curdling things to yell at the enemy?
Well, our own regiment's battle cry is London and Liberty.
London and Liberty. London and Liberty!
Aye.
Where did they pull me?
Well, unfortunately, even during Heritage Day, it rains occasionally, so we've all rushed into the Cooper's house to find that something strange is on the boil. It looks to me like a fearsome Civil War stew, and this lady here ladling it about. It looks absolutely awful, actually. Madam, what's your name?
It's Mistress Michelle.
Mistress Michelle. What have you put into that pot of delightful mess?
Well, we have rabbits.
Yes.
And chicken. And lamb, carrots, onions, potatoes, anything that will nourish the troops today because it's raining and it's cold on occasion, so
indeed.
They need something.
I see. And there's no sort of leg of newt or eye of toad or anything like that in them?
That'd be witchcraft, sir.
You're absolutely right.
I could get hung for you saying things like that, sir. Please do not.
I do apologise. Now, how many will this feed?
Well, we have 50 with us today, possibly. If it's, we'll just have to make it go round. It's all we have.
Yes. Well, it looks absolutely delicious, actually. And now, come on, tell me the truth. It's Heinz, isn't it?
No, sir. Definitely not.
Definitely not.
Definitely.
Wholesome stuff.
Wholesome
well,
stuff.
Can I have a little taste of that later?
If you come back, sir, yes, it would be a couple of hours before it's ready.
Right, well, I shall look forward to that. It's no wonder those Civil War people are tough if they have to eat something like this.
There are just
Well, Heritage Day is all about keeping alive those arts and crafts that used to keep the peasants going in the old ages. And we're lucky that a bunch of ladies in Southend are keeping alive the old arts of spinning and weaving and things. And the chairman is Eileen Cross. Eileen, now, it's absolutely fantastic what you're doing here. You start off with actual wool from a sheep, do you?
We do, yes. The sheep, this particular sheep's name is Kate.
Yes.
And it was only sheared 2 weeks ago.
Yes.
Having had triplets this year. And I soaked the fleece before we started just to wash out the real filth. And
yes,
we're now together today spinning it and carding it first and spinning it and plying it and knitting it into a garment. You see, we have knitters around, one on the front, one on the back, two on sleeves. We hope to finish a garment by the end of the day.
How many members have you got in this group then?
30. Yes, approximately 30.
Yes. And what's the attraction? What's the attraction of sitting here spinning like this when you could use a nice knitting machine or buy a sweater from Marks and Spencer's?
Well, it's all a matter of opinion, isn't it? This is our hobby and we enjoy it. I enjoy this more than the knitting of it, actually. And there's also the weaving side of it. It's a craft.
Yes.
An ancient craft that we're keeping alive.
Right, now as you can see, we've changed places so that Eileen can show me exactly how to do this. Now, Eileen, please, it's rather greasy.
It is, it's very greasy. It's best to spin while it's greasy because the fibres then slide against each other.
Right. The secret then, the secret.
There is no secret, it's a matter of practice. Right, put your foot on the treadle,
yes.
That's right. Now keep treading.
Oops.
Keep treading. That's right. Now, just.
Yes.
Okay, now pull out, pull back.
Pull back.
And let go with this hand and let the spin run up there.
Yes.
Pull back.
I'm doing well here, aren't I?
You are, you're doing well. Famous.
Whoa.
Pull back. Let the spin come up.
Yes.
Whoops.
Whoops.
Have a large lump. Pull back. That's it, the spin comes up. I think we're spinning rope here.
Are we right? We're glad to hear it.
Look, we're getting very overspun. You must work.
Whoops.
You're not working hard enough.
I'm not. I no. It's very difficult keeping.
Let some through.
Right, well, there we are.
A big smile. How's that? Are you going to make a spinner?
I don't think so, actually. I don't think so. Hold on, I've spoken now. Come on, it is very difficult keeping your feet going at the same time as your hands, isn't it, ladies?
It is.
Yes. Well, it is. I hate to be chauvinist about this, but it definitely is a woman's work, isn't it?
Thank you.
Heritage Day wouldn't be complete without some Morris dancing, but surely they're women, aren't they? Sacrilege! Personally, I prefer women Morris dancers. I think they look a lot better than men, don't you? Well, Heritage Day doesn't just mean recreating all those arts and crafts. It also means recreating some of the nasty ways we had of doing away with each other back in the old days. And with me now is Clive Hughes of Basildon Disabled Sports Club. Clive, you brought your archery here today, which is always very popular, isn't it?
With, most definitely.
Is it so the kids would go for this sort of thing?
Yeah, kids, the adults, anybody.
Right, now I've always wanted to try this since watching those old Errol Flynn films, you know, Robin Hood and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But it's not as easy as it looks, is it?
No, certainly not. It's a lot of hard work.
Yeah, can you show me how to do it then?
Well, this is a basic training bow.
Yes.
Basic training arrow. As you see with the arrow, two different colours.
Yes.
One, the odd colour is called a cocking fletch.
Yes.
Which always faces away from the bow to ensure that the arrow can pass through the bow quite well.
Right, okay. Then.
This is a knock. The knock goes onto a knocking point.
Yes.
Right. And we then have the arrow.
Lovely.
When we hold the arrow, we hold the handle with the hand straight. The string is one finger above, two below,
yep.
Keeping the string near the fingertips.
Yep.
This bow arm will go out with a slight...
Oh, eh?
Sorry about that.
It's all right, I won't be able to hit them.
Sorry.
Whoops, they keep slipping off.
Yeah, it's because you're bouncing it about. Everything must be done smoothly.
Right.
You keep this elbow up, level with your shoulder, and then draw the hand back to the side of the face, sighting all the time.
It's quite difficult, it's very strong, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, yeah. The fingers need to harden up on the string as you shoot. Once you've shot half a dozen times or so, they start hardening.
I'm going to go another one, haven't I?
Of course. Again, keep the cocking fletch outwards all the time, one above, two below. Just try and keep your bow arm a little bit bent. That's it, and then draw this one back. It's pretty good.
Whoa!
And look nice at that. Gold with the last
nice
one.
Nice gold, isn't
what
it?
A beautiful shot.
Now, Clive, you're disabled. Does that cause any sort of difficulties when it comes to doing things
like that? No, not with archery. There's a lot of sports we can do from wheelchairs.
Yes.
And thankfully archery is one of them.
Very true.
And we can do it on the same path as able-bodied.
Mm. I mean, do you think it's important that several people such as yourself continue doing sports?
Of course, yeah. Most important. I'm a firm believer in if you become disabled, it doesn't mean you can't do anything. You can do archery, you can do bowls, you can play tennis, you can play hockey, you can play basketball. You name it, you can do it. Water sports. You know, a lot of them you can do on the same path as able-bodied people.
So the message perhaps to disabled people is don't sit at home.
That's right.
Worrying about it, get out there, join the club.
That's right.
Get involved in things like this, which I think is
most definitely, yeah.
One more try, I think.
Oh, it's
narrow, but. Let's see if we can get you with another goal. Same procedure. One above, two below.
Ah.
Over the top.
Over the top, that one. Typical. Clive,
well
thanks
done.
Very much.
It's really good.
Cheers.
Well done. You'd make a good archer.
Oh, I think so.
Yeah. Plenty of practice and you'd do great.
We've seen beekeeping, we've seen spinning and weaving, what else? We've seen Morris dancing, and we've seen Civil War battles, all part of the rich pageant of history. Hope you enjoyed our little look at the Heritage Day here at Wat Tyler. And before we go, just want to remind you that Wat Tyler's open all the year round, and a good place to visit even when people aren't knocking seven bells out of each other in Civil War uniform. So from me, Kevin Furbank, very goodbye. Money left. Money left. Money left. Money left. Money left. Money left.